what are the units of volume percentage? Here, see, it is also a fraction of two volumes, volume of solute and volume of solution, ml, ml. So ml by ml means no units. So volume fraction, that means volume percentage also has no units. How does it depend on temperature? See, here there is volume term, that's why it depends on temperature, depends on T. So this is about volume percentage. Now how the questions will be asked on this? Here also volume of a solute will be given, volume of solvent will be given. We have to find out the volume percentage. See one example for it. Suppose volume of solute is given some 5 ml, volume of solvent is given some 6 ml or 10 ml. Now what is the volume percentage? So for that substitute their values, V2 5, but V means V1 plus V2, that means 5 plus 10 15. So 5 by 15 into 100, that means 1 by 3 into 100, 100 by 3 means 33.33, that is volume percentage. This is second concentration term. Next go to third term, that is mass by volume percentage. Mass by volume percentage. In this it is denoted by small w by capital V. See its formula. It is W2 into 100 by V. What is W2? I already said that W2 is the weight of solute. V is the volume of solution. That means volume of solute plus volume of solvent. So now here weight by volume of solution into 100. So how to define it? If V is taken as 100, then 100, 100 cancelled out, leaving W2. That means weight of solute is nothing but mass by volume in 100 ml solution. So mass by volume percentage means it is the weight of solute present in 100 ml of solution. Now here, what are the units? In the numerator there is weight, in the denominator volume. That's why its units are gram per ml. Its units are gram per ml. How does it depend on temperature? There is volume term. There is volume term in the denominator. That's why it depends on temperature. Depends on T. How? Volume is in the denominator. You know, T and V are directly proportional. So as T and V are directly proportional and V is inversely proportional to percentage W by V, this mass by volume percentage is inversely proportional to temperature. That means increase in temperature decreases the mass by volume percentage. This mass by volume percentage is widely used in pharmaceuticals. Widely used in pharmaceuticals. This is mass by volume percentage. Next, fourth one, parts per million. Parts per million, denoted by PPM, parts per million. See its formula. PPM is equal to weight of solute into 10 power 6 by weight of solution. So here 10 power 6, why it is taken here? Million means 10 power 6, that's why. Here WD is the weight of the solute, capital W is the sum of weights of solute plus solvent. Generally this PPM, this concentration term, is used for solutes which are present in very tracer amounts. That means if you take fluoride ion concentration in water, that is expressed in ppm, because fluoride ion concentration in water is very low. If it is 1 ppm, that is acceptable level. If it crosses 1 ppm, that is a polluted water and a toxic water. So for such a tracer amounts, similarly air pollutants, so pollutants in air also expressed as parts per million. What are its units and how to define it? First let's see the definition for it. How to define it? If W, that means weight of solution, is taken as 10 power 6, then 10 power 6 get cancelled, W2 will be left. W2 means weight of solute. So weight of solute present in 10 power 6 grams of water is called parts per million. Weight of solute present in 10 power 6 grams of solution is called ppm. Its units, weight by weight, that means ratio. So no units. Next, does not depend on T. Does not depend on T. Why? Because there is no volume term, that's why.